Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. So, what is this? This is my new pop-up design. It is a pop-up hut or house, and it even has a doorway. And if you look inside the house, it even has some foldable chairs that fold down so that the elders in the village, the three elders, can sit down and have their meeting. So there it is, the foldable house. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. So this model I folded from a 6-inch square of this tie-dye paper that I got at the Origami convention, but I'm going to show you how to fold it from a 10-inch square because it's easier to see. I chose green because we want an environmentally green building project, so here it goes. White side up, let's fold diagonally in half. And unfold and rotate 90 degrees, and let's fold diagonally in half in this direction. And we're going to start out by making a water bomb base. So let's fold this corner up to here. And turn over right to left. And let's fold this corner up to here. And rotate. And now let's open up the big white pocket. Put your finger all the way inside. And flatten it down so that it is a triangle, otherwise known as a water bomb base. All right, so here we got our water bomb base. And now we're going to fold this corner to here, but we're just going to make a little pinch right here, just to mark the midpoint here. Okay, now let's rotate, and let's fold this edge up right to the crease where the crease hits the edge. So right here. And unfold. And now we're going to reverse fold this flap. So what that means is that you have to open it up a little bit. And this valley fold needs to be made as a mountain fold. So reach in and go right along the fold with your pinchers, making it stick up like a mountain fold. We also have to reverse this crease so that it's a valley fold. So push it in and let's squeeze these two edges together, making the fold in the middle as a valley fold. And flatten it. Okay, and I'm gonna fast forward this. Now let's fold this flap up so that this corner goes to the midpoint. Now let's fold this flap up so that this edge goes to right here. Okay, unfold and unfold. And now we're going to make a reverse fold, and this is how it works. Lift up this top layer, single layer, and we're going to reverse this flap right into this slot. So we just push it inside like that. And I'm going to show this from another angle, so undo. It's just, we take this and it folds just like that, and we flatten. Okay, now we're going to take this flap and fold it on top like this, right on this edge, and unfold, and let's tuck it inside. And now we're going to take this flap right here and fold it inside right on the existing crease. So just like that. And you see the corner is nice and locked. And now we have to do the same thing on the other three corners. So here goes. So we're going to pull this to here. And let's fold this to here. And unfold the flap and lift up this layer, and we're going to reverse fold this flap right into this slot like this, and fold this up and unfold, and now fold this inside, and now fold this inside like this. And this one's locked. Okay, let's turn over right to left and do the same thing on these two flaps. And I'm gonna fast forward this. Now let's rotate and let's fold this flap up right on these two corners. I guess let's fold this corner up to here, rather. Okay, and now we're going to fold this edge to this edge. So we're folding right on this point, and we're just folding from this corner to the crease. Just like that, and unfold. And let's do the same thing. We're going to fold this edge to this edge, and we're folding from this corner to the crease. And unfold, and now we're going to fold this flap up right on this point right here, and just go through all layers. Try to keep it horizontal. If you really want to be exact, you can match this crease up with this crease to make sure that it's horizontal. Okay, and unfold and turn over, and now we are ready to open it up. So I'm gonna zoom out, and let's first fold this page over and fold this page over so that there is a page that's pointing in each direction. And now just reach in and open it up like a house. This. Now we're going to fold right along these diagonal pieces. We're going to make them into mountain folds. So, okay, let's start. Here we go. We're going to make a mountain, and a mountain, a mountain, a mountain, a mountain. Okay, there we are. And at this point, we can just push this in, and this is the new side of the house. You see, the old corner of the house becomes the side of the house. And push in right here, and push here, and push here. And let's make these as mountain folds. Just like that, and there is your house. Okay, so that's a simple version. You can end there if you want, but if you do want to make a doorway, then this is how to do it. So just choose any corner. You're going to unfold this corner, so just open it up and pull out the flap and carefully unfold it completely. Okay, now we're going to mountain fold right on this crease right here, all the way across. Okay, and now we're going to take this crease, make it into a fold, and we're going to fold it so that this edge is parallel with this middle crease right here. And just do that to eye. And let's do the same thing with this edge. So fold it and fold it down so that it's parallel with this crease. So when we do that, you see, when we press right here, we're actually making the fold. Okay, so here's our doorway, and it can go down like this. But if you want it a little bit taller, there's a way to do that, and this is how to do it. What I'm first going to do is make mountain folds right along this edge, right on this layer right here. Okay, and now, I'm going to zoom in. Now we're going to make a reverse fold right on this point. So we're going to fold this edge to this edge, fold it up, and pinch. So we just bisected this angle. And now we're going to fold this edge to this edge, like that, and they pinch together. And this is like a rabbit ear, see? Boom. And let's do the same thing on this side. So we fold this edge to here and this edge to this crease and flatten. Okay, now let's fold the flaps apart like this. So it looks like this from inside. And let's take this flap and we're going to mountain fold it inside. Like that. So this is what it looks like from inside. And here we have our doorway right here. And let's make a mountain fold that attaches here. This is going to be the awning. And now just form the roof like this. And this should be a mountain fold. Here, a mountain fold here, and here we have our hut. You zoom out, and just sculpt it to taste. Try to make it look a little bit more architecturally sound and clean. Is. Now to collapse it, what you want to do is make this is the mountain fold and fold this part of the roof down, and this whole thing becomes a valley fold. And this is a mountain fold, and this is a valley fold. From inside, I'm just treating these flaps as part of the side of the house. I'm just folding them however they go. Okay, and this is a valley fold. This is a mountain fold. And lastly, this, right in between the doorway, is a mountain fold. So it just closes up. This. Voila, there it is. And the, I don't know, paper airplane. A paper airplane that turns into a house. Okay, let's open it back up into the house. And there is the hut. And let's see what else you could make furniture. So how to do that? Let's make a chair. Let's just make chairs. So what you do is you unfold this part right here. And well, you could just fold it down and there's a bench or something like that. But if you do sort of a pedal fold like this, if you fold this down, then this is the back of the chair. Right here, and let's see, squash this up like that, and then this can be folded into an avant-garde chair. a new age chair, and then this could be folded behind like that. So there is the back of the chair, the seat, and the legs of the chair. And when you look in the house, there you see the chair. That. And you can do the same thing on the other three flaps. I'm not going to do that, but you can. And oh, when you want the chair to fold up, just fold it up like this, flatten it, and now flatten the house. And voila, and you can fly away. Whoosh. All right, well, if you guys were able to fold that, and now you are the owner of a hut, a green building, and it could also be a cup, or what else could it be? It could be a top. There you go. Whoosh. Well, maybe it's a house in a tornado. There you go. All right, well, hope you enjoyed that, and catch you later.